स्टैंडर्ड 9, सब्जेक्ट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, लेसन नंबर 15, लाइफ प्रोसेसेस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। लेट अस सी अबाउट द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन। वी हैव स्टडीड हाउ डाइजेस्टेड फूड आर ऑक्सीजन इनहेल्ड बाय लंग्स इज ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू एवरी सेल ऑफ द ह्यूमन बॉडी। द फार्मर ऑल्सो ट्राइज टू ट्रांसपोर्ट द वाटर फ्रॉम वेल्स आर डैम्स through a main channel to every plant. The food absorbed by the digestive system is converted into energy. This energy and oxygen are both transported via blood throughout the body. Now see how we can define the transportation. Transportation is a process by which substances are either synthesized or absorbed in one part of the body and reaches to the another. Now let us see transportation in plants. Most animals move from place to place, but plants do not. There are many dead cells in the plant body. They need less energy as compared to the animals. Plants need inorganic substances like nitrogen, phosphorus, magnesium, manganese, sodium, etc. Soil is the nearest and richest source of these substances. Roots of the plants absorb these substances from the soil and transport them. These are a specific type of the tissue to perform this function. The xylem conduct the water, whereas phloem conduct the food. That's why both are called as the conducting tissue. All parts of the plant are connected with these conducting tissue. Root cells are in contact with water and minerals in the soil. Water and minerals enter the cells on the root surface due to the difference in the concentration. As a result, these cells become turgid. These turgid cells exert the pressure on the adjacent cells. This is called root pressure. Under the effect of this pressure, water and minerals reaches the xylem of the roots and reduce these differences in concentration. They are continuously pushed forward. As a result of this continuous movement, a water column is formed, which is continuously pushed ahead. This pressure is sufficient to lift the water up in the shrub, small plants, and small trees. Now let us see about the transpiration pool. Plants give out water in the form of the vapor through the stomata on their leaves. Two cells called guard cells are present around the stomata. These cells control the opening and closing of stomata. Transpiration occurs through these stomata, and water is released into the atmosphere by leaves through the process of evaporation. As a result, water level in the epidermal layer of the leaf decreases. Water is brought up to the leaves through the xylem so as to compensate for the lost water. Transpiration helps in the absorption of the water and mineral and distribution to all parts of the plants, whereas root pressure performs the important role of pushing the water up during the night time. Now, all of you see here, the oak trees release about 151,000 liters of water into the air by the process of transpiration in 1 year, whereas a maize crop in an area of 1 acre gives out about 11,400 to 15,100 liters of water per day. Now let us see about the excretion in plant. Removal of the waste or harmful substances from the body is called excretion. In unicellular organism, waste material are directly eliminated across the cell surface, whereas the process of excretion in multicellular organism is complex. Now let us see about the excretion in plants. Excretion is a simpler process in plants than the animals. There is no special organ or system for excretion in the plant. Gaseous substances are given out by diffusion. most of the waste substances of the plant are stored in the vacuoles of the leaf cells and in flowers, fruits, and the bark of the stem. After some time, these parts fall off. Some other waste material are stored in old and worn xylem in the form of the resins and gums. Some waste materials are also given out through the root into the surrounding of the soil. And in some plants, waste materials are present in the form of the crystals of calcium oxalate. They are called rhyophytes. As they are needle shaped, they prickles and causes the irritation of the skin. Some waste material of the plants are useful to humans, for example, gum, resin, latex of rubbers. Thank you.